Hey, Justin, how are you? A couple of days off. You're back in the postseason after 2 years after the first game. How you feel about this first game, and what are the keys for the victories for the Houston Astros, whoever they face?
Yeah, I am excited, yes. I've been working hard, to get my mechanics where I want them, and kind of fix a few bad habits that have crept in. I'm excited to get back out there. I feel good. And to answer your question about what we need to do, I mean, pitch well, score more runs than the other team.
I'm going right over here with Daniel.
You touched on this a little bit after your last start, just mentioned that you had identified some things that that you wanted to fix. Now that you've had a few more days, is there anything else you can share with us, without giving too much away?
I mean, I don't really need to, I'm not giving anything away. I think, since the calf injury, coming back, hasn't been as consistent as I would like. I was on a pretty good stretch there before that. And then you see, like, Adam Wainwright, for example, he tweets out after the season that his lower body injury, kind of messed with his mechanics. And, even though mine wasn't severe, little tweaks to the lower half, I mean, you hear pitchers talk about it all the time. We work so hard on our legs and lower body strength because that's where we generate from. So any little tweaks to the lower half can have major effects upstream. I'm very thankful that it wasn't a major injury, and I don't think it was a big issue, but it did probably create a little bit of mechanical issues, and I've been working on that ever since I came back, been working really hard, and I think hopefully after the last one, I identified some stuff that was kind of a key component, and it's just kind of mechanical stuff that really probably shouldn't really go too far into. It's just we don't need to go that deep into the woods.
On the right, Chandler.
Justin, when you first saw Alvarez in 2019 when he came up here, I guess what has surprised you maybe about him in his evolution into being a complete player?
I mean, I can't really say much has surprised me. When somebody comes up at that age and is that mature at the plate already, I think you realize how special of a talent he is. So, I think when you see how high the ceiling is for someone like that, then whatever he accomplishes isn't necessarily surprising. It's impressive, but I don't think anybody's surprised by how successful or how great he is. He's been, when he first came up, he was playing on, one leg basically. His knee was all banged up, and he was still that impressive at the plate. So I think, once he got that fixed and he's healed, I think this is just the player that he is. And I don't mean to say that, but surprising isn't the word I would use. I'm definitely impressed day in and day out with how great he is, but not surprised.
You usually know who you're going to face a few days out. So what is the situation at other series sort of affect your preparation for tomorrow?
Yeah, I think, it does a little bit. Maybe just causes you a little more homework. But, as far as, like, preparation for myself, it doesn't really change anything. I'm really thankful for the extra few days to continue to work on some mechanical adjustments. So, I'd rather have it that way than the other way.
Thanks, Justin. The short rest discussion is one you're familiar with from throughout your career, and obviously it's a key storyline in the New York and Cleveland series right now. I'm just curious about, in your time going on short rest, how has your view of that changed, evolved, in terms of what you have to do to prepare to do it? And also, the other part of it is, I've always heard that command is the harder thing to do versus velocity. Would you agree with that in terms of what's most challenging on short rest?
Well, interesting question. I've only done it once. That was 19 postseason against Tampa Bay. I came out of the bullpen before in Boston in the playoffs, which I wouldn't consider short rest. I guess it's just a different thing. But starting on short rest, I guess the thing that I felt was most impacted was my off speed. I felt like the control and the velocity were fine. The off-speed stuff, the spin, is a little harder to kind of locate and get where you want. Also, I think I mean, you know, I go pitch on short rest in 19, and, you know, my next start in regular season, I blew out. You know, I don't know if that is correlated or not. You know, we put it all on the line, though, and it's asking a lot of your body to do that, especially, you know, when you're not used to it. It's just one of those things. You know, we get in such a routine. Our season's so long, and you, as a starting pitcher, you're just like, okay, you just get embedded in your routine, and then all of a sudden you just totally shake things up, and, I don't think it's easy. I don't think it's easy on your body. But under all the adrenaline and, you know, everything else, I felt remarkably normal. Looking back, though, I think my spin suffered most. And to answer a possible follow-up, I don't regret it. You know, we're here in the playoffs. This is what what you envision as a kid. You know, you're not in your backyard, playing with your dad and saying, here we are in the last game of a series in May against the whatever team. You're saying, you know, here we are in the playoffs in the World Series, Game 7. You know, that's what you envision as a kid. So, there's only one thing to do is just go out and do it. You know, make no excuses.
Justin, remember in spring training in 2020 when you guys were dealing with all the fallout from everything, Dusty had just been hired, and you spoke very highly of him then. Now that you've been around for 3 years and you guys just came through that series of 106 wins this year, what's your general opinion of him as a manager and his ability to relate to you and the veterans, but also the younger guys on a team that's continued to change year after year here?
Yeah, I think you nailed it with, you know, he relates to his players. I think he takes a lot of pride in that. I think he really tries to get to know everybody individually and understand what makes them tick, and try to connect with them on a more than just a manager player type level. And that goes a long way. You know, you see, the celebration in Seattle the other day. You know, we waited on Dusty, and he comes into the locker room and does, you know, he does his thing, and everybody, you know, it makes everybody smile, it makes everybody happy. He's always, you know, I think you know that he's always got your back. He's always rooting for the best in you, and that's all you can really ask for as a player. So I've really enjoyed getting to know him also personally, and just play for him.
For those of us who never make it back past the backyard playing catch with Dad, can you speak to a little more of the homework? I mean, after you know the result tonight, will you dive into some film, maybe some scouting reports? Is that maybe what gives you the extra homework tonight?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, I mean, you I think you want to know your opponent as well as possible. So, after we figure out who we're playing tonight, then it's like a cram session for a test the next day that you're probably a little late for, but you still got time to get all the answers or at least do the studying that you need. That's what it would be like.
Justin, do you worry as the playoffs keep expanding that it will become more likely for a team that maybe gets hot for a couple weeks in October will win over a team that's been great over the course of the year?
Concern, but it's just one of those things that you just don't really talk about. You just don't want to think about it that way. But I think as you see the first round this year, I mean, some of the best teams got knocked out, and it's hard to say whether that was coincidence or not. It's kind of a recipe to set that up because, as we've seen in playoffs time and time again, the hot team is really difficult to beat in general, and then so you take the best teams in the regular season, have them take off 5 days, which we're not used to, and then have the hot team keep playing. You play a 3-game series and then come out of that and go right in to keep playing. And, if you're not ready, especially in a shortened series, I think you can see how easily you can lose that series. I mean, we were very fortunate the first night to have, to have a comeback like that. Otherwise, we would have been in a very tough position. As the best team in the American League, playing a great team, no doubt, but they were hot and they came out hot. Thank goodness we were able to get it going, but if you don't, you could be in trouble. So, I don't know how it's going to play out. I don't know if the league sees what happens and maybe wants to make tweaks. I don't know what those tweaks would look like, but, expanding the playoffs, it brings in a lot of revenue, so I don't think it's going to go backwards.
We'll go in the middle of the beat.
Justin, you're on record saying you want to pitch into your 40s. What motivates you at this point? Is it games like this? Is it statistical milestones? What keeps you wanting to pitch like you do?
I love the game. I love competing. I've always been one of those, I don't know, it's just never been a doubt in my mind. I just want to play until they rip the jersey off me. I'm not going to be out there making a fool of myself, don't get me wrong, but, it's just the way I've always envisioned it. You know, you see the greats of the past, and those guys pitched to their 40s. It was never a question in my mind that if you want to be great, that's what you have to do. So I've prepared myself to do that since I started throwing a baseball. And, I think with that mentality, you know, you have a long-term vision and goal, and I don't know, maybe I just manifest it. I don't know, but I love playing. I love, like I said, the competition, the one-on-one. It's just, I love being around my teammates, and, you know, we have such a short window as athletes to play the game that, you know, really has defined my life up to this point, up until I got married and had my daughter. When I'm done, 50, 60, 70, hopefully later, and, you know, I would never want to look back with regret that I didn't find out how far I could take this. I mean, I obviously was gifted to throw a baseball, so why would I stop that short?
One more on the front.
Hey, Justin, not that you're surprised about the staff and what your staff can do, but can you just talk about having a complete staff, including the bullpen, that just has so much depth and the kind of talent you have?
Yeah, I mean, it's been really impressive all season long. I mean, these guys, make it easy on me as a starter, all the other starters, all the guys in the bullpen, whether it's coming out of the game a little earlier than I would like, but, you know, the guy coming behind me is elite, maybe I have a short start, or we lose a game, or whatever, and then, you know, the next starter is great. It's been really impressive, I've been part of some really good pitching staffs, top to bottom. I think most notably the starting pitchers I've been with have been incredible on some teams, and this rivals that. I mean, I think what makes looking back some of those starting staffs that I was part of so impressive is what the resumes of guys that went on from that went on to do. So, I mean, who knows how good some of these guys are going to end up being in a few years, but, I mean, it's just a lot of fun to watch, and I would put us right up there as a starting staff against some of the best teams I've ever been a part of. And then the bullpen is, I mean, probably, if not the best, one of the best bullpens I've been a part of as well. So, just really impressive, and, you see how hard it is to score runs against us, besides me, in the first series. Makes it a lot easier to win baseball games.
Dusty, anything you want to know?
No, I'll ask you.
Yeah, thanks, everybody.